In the latest version of SAP Lumira, a new extension is available that enables users to acquire data directly from SAP BW queries or from OLAP connections that have been created on the SAP Business Objects Business Intelligence platform. These datasets can then be enriched and combined with datasets from other sources through merging or data blending. Stories built using SAP BW data can be published to SAP Lumira Cloud and all editions of SAP Lumira Server. When acquiring data from Hadoop, Hive, or Impala, users can sample the data. This enables users to define the tasks required to cleanse the data and to gain insights using a manageable number of records, and then to automatically recreate these data transformations and visualizations using the full Hadoop cluster. Note that some features are not available because of the size of the dataset. Users can now acquire multiple SAP HANA views from the same instance. When adding a dataset within the Prepare workspace, the same instance automatically opens, enabling another view to be selected. These views can then be combined through merging or data blending. In addition, users can display SAP HANA variable labels within SAP Lumira rather than displaying technical names. In the Prepare workspace, users can now apply transformations to date-time data down to hours, minutes, and seconds. Time hierarchies and calculated dimensions can also take advantage of the greater level of detail. In addition, a new line chart is available for date-time series that has been optimized for time-based hierarchies and dimensions with a continuous time scale. Note that date-time values acquired from Microsoft Excel are still identified as strings and must be converted to the appropriate date-time format. If the structure of an existing data source has been changed, when the dataset is refreshed, SAP Lumira detects those changes and displays a new data mapping dialog box, where users can remap or remove the affected columns. SAP Lumira now supports data blending as an alternative to merging datasets. While merging relies on traditional table joins and results in a permanently merged table, data blending uses separate SQL statements to query each dataset at runtime and creates a temporary join based on a shared dimension. Data blending takes place in the Visualize workspace. When a user switches datasets in the middle of building a visualization, SAP Lumira intuits that a data blending situation is desired and prompts the user to identify the shared dimension between the two datasets. The shared dimension does not need to be a unique key, as it does when merging. Multiple relationships can be defined and are thereafter available globally for the document. Data blending is available on the SAP Lumira Server for BI Platform, Server for Teams, and Desktop editions. Can be applied to any acquired data source, including SAP BW, and can be published to both Server for BI Platform and Server for Teams. Note that publishing is not available to SAP Lumira Server for HANA or SAP Lumira Cloud, as they do not use the Velocity Data Engine. All existing tables in SAP Lumira have been converted to the Crosstab format. In this format, measures are displayed in columns and dimensions are displayed in rows. Users can apply conditional formatting, navigate hierarchies, and manually adjust column sizes. Several new calculations have been added to the latest release to enable users to better identify trends and other insights. Running calculations and moving averages include options to reset values at a specified level and exclude empty values. The percentage of calculation shows a measure's value as a percentage of a selected subtotal in the hierarchy. The calculation can be applied on trellis totals and grand totals. The difference from calculation enables users to analyze performance trends by performing a value comparison on different subsets of the measure values, such as year over year. Users can compare growth or decline between different time periods and set options for base value, base dimension, and percentage display. Note that users can compare values across datasets when data blending is in effect. All calculations can easily be created and edited from both the toolbar and the chart feeder panel. Conditional formatting has been extended to include bar and column charts. In the chart section of the user preferences, the standard chart color palettes have been redesigned and enhanced with a new option to define measure-based coloring for chart types such as heat maps and tree maps. New charts inherit the default color palette from the user preferences. However, now users can apply new colors to individual charts using the settings menu. Additional enhancements have been made to the default font styling and positioning of chart elements, such as adjusting the size and shape of the color indicators in legends, providing angled display of long axis labels, and improving the appearance of axis line and tick marks. The filter dialog box now provides tokenized value for easy selection and removal, enables users to type values that are not included in the dataset, and allows comma separated values to be pasted into the list. In the Compose workspace, reports, infographics, and boards have been combined into a single story format that supports all objects. Existing stories are automatically converted to this format in the latest version of SAP Lumira. Some adjustments have been made to the chart layout options to ensure that the elements in charts of the same size are aligned. More space has also been added for labels and other text. In preview mode for a story, users can filter on data points within a visualization, and the filter will automatically update all other visualizations on the same page. This applies also to excluding values and drilling up and down in a hierarchy. Users can also export selected values from a visualization as a CSV file or Microsoft Excel spreadsheet based on the underlying dataset and any applied filters. This feature is available in both the Visualize and Compose workspaces, as well as in online consumption and exploration modes. Properties are now available for input controls in the Compose workspace, enabling users to choose between a list box and a combo box, and to choose between single and multiple selection. These controls can be positioned over existing objects to maximize the use of space on the page. Note that the controls can be applied across objects from multiple datasets if desired. Users can also copy and paste elements within the same story in the Compose workspace. In the Prepare, Visualize, and Compose workspaces, users can take advantage of undo and redo actions to experiment with their data. For this version of SAP Lumira, SAP HANA revisions 82, 83, 84, and 85 are supported for productive use. Revisions 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, and 95 are for test and evaluation only. Revision 96 is now supported for productive use, but users may experience reduced performance. Refer to SAP Note 202-1789 for details. Also, SAP Lumira Server for BI Platform and Server for Teams now includes support for SAP Business Objects, Business Intelligence Platform 4.1, Service Pack 6. Visit the SAP Store to download SAP Lumira free today.